Savior, who was nailed to the cross for me.
Thank you. come climb over me and love me like their friends told me. For a world for a gift such as I, the Father grant, the Savior went and died. Redemption for a worthless sinner. His heart a son, he asks me not to fill a servant's place. The far off country wanderings all undone, wide open are his arms and grace. Such love, such wondrous love, such love, such wondrous love.
Thursday evening. Tomorrow is Good Friday. So we're happy to be able to present some of these great old gospel songs. Lorna, some of the folk are listening in. I think with the daylight being here longer, maybe some of the folk are still out doing their gardening or getting their raking done.
Mm-hmm.
But anyways, who's listening in so far?
Okay, we have Sandy McDonald Patterson.
Hi, Sandy.
So she's
McDonald
our niece.
Lorna's got your name.
That's
over
what,
there.
Nice Joanne you. Hooper.
Joanne, nice to have you, Joanne, again.
Al Blackmere.
And Al. What city is Al in?
I don't know.
No? Maybe Al, you can tell us.
And Bev Dice. I can't get this thing to move properly. Bev Dice is watching.
Yeah.
Al Christine. Lucido, and Jim and Jane Ralston,
down in Woodstock,
Edith Rizal,
Edith.
Ross Anderson,
that's the family church, Edith is,
yeah.
And Ralston's, yes,
Woodstock. Ross Anderson and Kathy Doze.
Ross and Kathy, nice.
Yeah.
Ross is in Woodstock and Kathy's up
and in Clay Colorado. Gunderson.
Clay is down in Cleveland, Tennessee.
And Michael...
Jay Fox.
It's a long name, but it's gone again.
Oh.
And Clay, did I say Clay? Yeah,
yeah.
I did. Okay. There's somebody I can't.
By the name of Michael there?
Yeah.
Maybe you can pick that up in a little while.
Rugged cross in the air.
thank you, Heavenly Father, that that's the real reason that we're celebrating this week and this weekend, because it was the willingness of Jesus to come from the glorious palace of heaven, come into this world to be born as a little babe, knowing that his destiny was the cross. It was his purpose in coming. And so we thank you, Lord, that although we don't turn the cross into a relic, we do remember that it was on that old rugged cross that Jesus died for us. He was willing to take our sin and shame, and he was willing to give us a pardon that we might be free from all sin. And for those, Lord, that are bound in sin tonight, I pray that there will be deliverance and freedom. I pray that there will be salvation, that there will be restoration. And I pray, Lord, that they will come to know Christ as their personal Savior over this weekend. We thank you, Lord, that you're a healing Jesus. And so we do pray for many that have contacted us over the last week or two or three, and even this week, the folks, Lord, that need the healing touch of God upon their lives, Jesus, to step into their lives, and in the midst of their infirmity and sickness and disease, that Jesus is able to teach them he probably is their last hope, their last possible place to turn. And so, Lord, when doctors have given up, we're glad that we can turn to Jesus. And we're glad that he can bring the peace into our hearts, that peace that passes the understanding of man, so that people will say to us in the midst of our sickness and infirmity, they will say, how can you be so at peace? How can you be so happy? How can you be able to survive this tragedy that's come upon you? And we're able to turn their eyes to Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, so that they can understand that our God is a great God who loves us and cares for us. So tonight, Lord, we pray for each of these by name. We do pray for Brother Al, and we do pray for Paul Dean, and we pray for Sam and Barb and Bruce and Mary and Edna. We pray for Karen and the family. And tonight, Lord, especially we pray for Ron and Tina, that your hand would be upon them, Lord, and the loss of their grandchild and the burial just this afternoon. So, Lord, may your peace come into their lives and into their hearts. May they look to you, Lord, for strength and hope, because our hope is in you alone. Thank you for this glorious weekend. May the Church of Jesus Christ celebrate as never before. May this be a time when we lift the name of Jesus high, so that our young people can see and understand, Lord, these are glorious days in spite of the difficulties and problems and trials, and nation rising against nation, and wars and rumors of wars, and insidious sin, and sickness and disease and death. Our God is still a God who conquers and reigns, and he reigns even this evening. So we give you praise and thanks in that powerful name that is above every name, at the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Well, there are sometimes I get to praying and I feel like there's so many things that need praying for. So we want to include you. If you have a prayer request, please contact us, let us know, and we'd be happy to do this. One of the great old songs that we learned many, many years ago, I probably learned this song probably 50, 60, 65 years ago, back when I was a kid of 10 or 11. And it's stuck with me all my life, and it's so so good, so appropriate here at the Easter season. As you can tell, I'm starting to lose my voice already. But that's okay, we can still sing. Thank you. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 There's a couple that I forgot to pray for, Lauren, and I thought maybe we should just take a moment and...
I think to Sharon and me. Would you pray?
So, Father, this evening again we come to you and we do pray especially for Sharon and the problem she's been having with her knee for the last several weeks. I pray, Lord, that you'll touch her and heal her. May the healing hand of Jesus rest upon her tonight, we pray. May it be a miracle, and may she give testimony of the goodness of God. And I do pray for Sibby and Sheila down in Atlanta. And sometimes, Lord, when we don't hear constant reports, we forget. But I do pray for both of them this evening. Sibby, as he's pastoring there in Chattanooga, and where they live in Atlanta, and Sheila's a nurse, I pray, Lord, that your hand would be upon her and you'd restore her 100% to her health and strength again, that she may continue to serve the church that they're in, and she may also continue to serve in the hospital where she works. For your glory, and your glory alone, may there be a healing upon her life. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen. Some very dear, very special friends. Hallelujah. Maybe you should check that, that camera again a little longer before we go into our next song.
Isabel Romero, Pastor John Smith, Karen Manship, Betty Humphreys.
Hi, Karen, and hi, Betty. Maybe, Betty, you could tell us if you're home at all yet from the south. So many are coming home. I think Rick and Enza came home today as well.
Yeah.
Saw a posting of them. And Karen, I think Karen's living in Wheatstock area. I'm happy to have every one of you joining with us. And the many that joined with us during the week, I was looking again earlier today, and just people from all over the place that are tuning in for our broadcast here on Facebook. If you could hit the like button, it helps us know who you are and the fact that you'd like us maybe to continue with these. As we approach summer, we begin to reevaluate whether there's still the need for these things of encouragement. So if you like, just hit the like button. If you want to share it, that's even better, because then you can share it with other people that need some words of encouragement. And then, of course, you can also ask to be a friend on our Facebook page, and we can friend you, and then you notice this as well when we're coming online. Thank you.
Yes, it's from John 19:38-42. Afterward, Joseph of Arimathea, who had been a secret disciple of Jesus, because he feared the Jewish leaders, asked Pilate for permission to take down Jesus' body. When Pilate gave permission, Joseph came and took the body away. With him came Nicodemus, the man who had come to Jesus at night. He brought about 75 pounds of perfumed ointment made from myrrh and aloes. Following Jewish burial custom, they wrapped Jesus' body with the spices in long sheets of linen cloth. The place of crucifixion was near a garden where there was a new tomb never used before. And so, because it was the day of preparation for the Jewish Passover, and since the tomb was close at hand, they laid Jesus there.
Thank you.
Old Testament with the story of the Garden of Eden, where God chose to come down and walk with man and talk with them in the garden. As we come across to the New Testament, we see Jesus going into the garden to pray to his Father just before he's being taken as a prisoner and loses his life. Contrast of the two gardens. The old garden they were cast out of. The new garden that Jesus was preparing to go to the cross at that time, that new garden would bring us eternal life. And he walks with me. And he walks with me. Again, we're glad that you joined us for our songs on this Thursday, just before Good Friday. We're heading off to church in the morning. I hope you are to your church as well. Happy to have our son-in-law's mother with us, Rose Heath from Cambridge.
She's usually here online.
Yeah, she's here, and she's usually saying hello, but she's right with us this evening. So happy to have her joining us. This is a great old gospel song. I just love this one.
Got some more people on here.
I think we'll end with this one in a few moments. Who else do you have there, Robert?
I have Donna. She's Donna, late, she says. Yep.
Yeah.
And Ron Hughes and Sherry Summers Langman and Jeremy Chapman.
Nice, yes.
And Sharon Lalikas.
And Sharon?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Hi, Sharon. Again. Amen. Wow, so good to have all of you here with us. And if you'll tell others, spread the word, they'll join during the week. Some people say they do their devotions the next day, Friday morning, as they listen to some of the background hymns here.
My riches pay, I come.
have a great Easter weekend, everyone. God bless.